हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज क्लास 7 केमिस्ट्री एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मॉलिक्यूल्स, ओके, एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मॉलिक्यूल्स सच एज हाइड्रोजन, नाइट्रोजन. देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ ए वाटर, देन एटमिसिटी. Then we have discussed monoatomic molecules, and today we will discuss diatomic molecules. So let us see what are diatomic molecules. So diatomic molecules are the molecule which are having two atoms in a single molecule. So what is a diatomic molecule? Molecules in which two atoms are called as diatomic molecule. Example is hydrogen, that is H2, then oxygen, that is O2, then chlorine, that is Cl2, and nitrogen, that is N2. That means what, students? All these gases are available in diatomic molecule form. That means in the nature, suppose if I take the example of a hydrogen balloon, suppose this is a balloon, and in this balloon hydrogen gas is there. So what will we get? Hydrogen atom? Will we get one hydrogen atom in this gas balloon? No. Single hydrogen atom cannot exist. So hydrogen atom combine with one more hydrogen atom and it forms H2. But H2 can now exist freely. So inside a hydrogen balloon gas, H2 will be present, not H. Similarly, oxygen also present, O2 in the form of O2. Chlorine is present in the form of Cl2, and nitrogen is also present in the form of N2. Next, we will see triatomic molecules. So, triatomic molecules, can you say what is triatomic molecules? It's very easy. So, what is the definition? Molecules which consist three atoms are called as triatomic molecules. What are the example of this? Example of triatomic is ozone. Yes, remember, ozone is a triatomic molecule and formula is O3. So here O2 is there. This is oxygen. O2 is oxygen, but O3 is ozone. Remember that. Next is, so we will understand only one example of triatomic molecule. Let us see that. Let us go to the, do you know where is ozone layer present? Yes, you are right. Suppose this is our earth. Now, above the earth, what is present? Atmosphere is present. Yes or no? So in the atmosphere, in the upper level, ozone layer is present. This is our ozone layer. So what is the work of ozone layer? As we know that from the sun, what rays come out? UV ray come out, ultraviolet rays comes, which is very harmful for us, very dangerous. So now ozone layer protect this UV rays. It protect us from the UV rays. It does not allow the UV rays to enter. Okay. So that ozone is nothing but O3. That means three atoms of oxygen combined to form one molecule of ozone molecule. Next we'll see polyatomic molecules. So what are polyatomic molecules? So molecules which are having more than three atoms. So molecules which consist of more than 3 atoms are called as polyatomic molecules. For example, phosphorus. Yes, phosphorus is a polyatomic molecule. Its formula is P8. That means 8 atoms. Sorry, it's not P8, it's P4. So that means 4 atoms of phosphorus combine to form a phosphorus molecule. Similarly, sulfur. Sulfur is S8. That means 8 atoms of sulfur combine to form sulfur molecules. Now we will see what is radicals. So now let us see what is radical. So radical, a radical is a single atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements. So radical is a single atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements behaving as a single unit and with a charge on the group. So let us understand what is a radical. So radical is a single atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements behaving as a single unit and with a charge on the group. So for example, if you take the example of ammonium radical. Ammonium radical. Its symbol will be NH4 plus 1. So here remember that nitrogen is one atom, hydrogen 4 atoms are there. So it is a group of total 5 atoms, 4 hydrogen atom, 1 nitrogen atom. Now entire this group is having a plus charge and due to this plus charge it is called as a radical. Clear? So radical will always have a charge. It may be plus 1, plus 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, plus 3. Any charge will always be there. If there is no charge, then it will not be called as a radical. But if it is having a charge, then it will be called as a radical. Now it can be one atom or more than one atom also. For example, if we take the example of chloride radical. So now chloride radical symbol will be Cl minus. So here you see only one atom is there, that is a chlorine atom. But since there is minus one charge is there, so it will also be called as radical. Okay. Now we will see how many types of radicals are there. Types of radical. So there are two types of radical, that is positive radical, okay, which is also called as basic radical. Remember that positive radicals are also called as basic radicals. Now what are positive radicals? So they will be having positive charge. Very simple. Radical which are having positive charge will be called as positive radical. Okay. And now what is a negative radical? negative radical is also known as acidic radical. Okay, and negative radical will be having what kind of charges? They will be having negative charges. Very simple. So remember that positive radicals are known as basic radicals and negative radicals are known as acidic radicals or acid radicals. Rather, it's not acidic, we can write it as acid radicals. Okay. So next we will understand what is valency. Students, no need to worry. I will send the notes. Okay. So now you understand and afterwards you can note it down in your copy from the PDF or by pausing the video. So next we'll see what is a valency. So valency of an element or radical is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine with or displace one atom of the element. Displaced by one atom of the element. Forming a compound. So now let us understand the meaning. So what is the meaning of the word valency? So valency of an element or radical is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine with or displace by one atom of the element. So valency is nothing but the number of hydrogen atoms a particular element can combine or it can be displaced. Let us take an example, then you will understand very clearly. Okay, so now if you see the example of HCl, now here what we can see that hydrogen is combining with chlorine. Now how many hydrogen atoms is combining with one atom of chlorine? You see chlorine, one atom is here, nothing is written, means one is written. So with one chlorine atom, how many hydrogen atoms is combining? One hydrogen atom is combining. So since with chlorine only one hydrogen atom is combining, so we can say that valency of chlorine is one. How we know the valency of chlorine? Because one chlorine atom is combining with one hydrogen atom. So here the definition is saying that valency of an element or radical is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine or displace by one atom of an element. So one atom of an element, here element is chlorine, it is our element. So one atom of chlorine combining with how many atom of hydrogen? One atom of hydrogen. So valency of chlorine is one here. Next, if you see the example of, suppose we'll see the example of ammonia, NH3. Here what we can see that nitrogen is combining with three atoms of hydrogen. So one atom of nitrogen is combining with how many hydrogen? Three atoms of hydrogen. So what we can say? We can say that valency of nitrogen is, valency of nitrogen is how much? It will be 3, because 3 hydrogen atoms are combining. So hydrogen atom is, imagine that hydrogen atoms are like ice creams. So now a name of a boy is Ajay. So Ajay can eat 2 ice creams. two hydrogen. So two ice creams. So what is the valency of Ajay? 2. Another girl is there, Meena. Now Meena can eat 5 ice creams. So what is the valency of Meena? It will be 5. So here ice cream is nothing but hydrogen. So chlorine can combine with 1 hydrogen. So valency of chlorine is 1. Here nitrogen can combine with 3 hydrogen atoms. So valency of nitrogen will be 3. Okay. So today we'll keep up to this much. We'll continue in the next class. Tata, bye-bye.